tragedy. An elderly woman who gets scammed out of money, a lot of money, calls the police, and the police scam her out of more money. It's a damn shame. All right, let's get into the details of this. Put up the precinct full mass here. You're looking at Australia. Yep, it happened in Australia. In Australia, a New South Wales police detective who was meant to help catch the criminals who stole $30,000 from an elderly woman. Instead, this cop tried to rob her himself. Let me give you background. Sonia, who's 74, who asked for only her first name to be used as she feared being targeted again, was robbed by fraudsters pretending to be National Broadband Network workers in May of 2021. They convinced her to transfer $30,000 to them before she then reported the incident to her local police after realizing she was the victim of a crime, okay? Then in June 2021, the detective, who cannot be named, went to Sonia's home several times to get details of what happened, often wearing his full police uniform. To gain her sympathy, he said he had a brain aneurysm and had not yet told his girlfriend or his job. According to police documents tendered to the court, she trusted him and he told her she, and I quote, reminded him of his own grandmother. This is the setup, right? The Daily Telegraph reported, when he posed a question, when he asked to see her online banking details, right? Because he's the detective, right? Credit cards, passwords, etc. Miss Sonia gave them to him, assuming they were needed for his investigation. He told Miss Sonia his girlfriend was calling him and she left the room to give him privacy. However, he did not have a call and the officer stole Sonia's banking details while she was in another room, the court heard. He waited a few days before trying to use them, then went on an online shopping spree. The detective tried to buy close to $20,000 worth of items from JB Hi-Fi, Big W, Meijer, and Meijer, including iPhones, GoPro cameras, Apple Watches, but none of the attempted purchases, which took place on July 2nd and 3rd, went through as they were all rejected as suspicious. This is a company dynamic. They say, well, she doesn't usually buy these things, so the algorithm kicked in. When he was arrested, all right, this was August 24th. Look at the timeline. The detective was charged with 57 separate offenses, which were reduced to 6 he pleaded guilty to. In court this week, the now former detective pleaded guilty to stealing Miss Sonia's money. All right, admitted to the bank he did it. He has also pleaded guilty to illegally looking up details on internal police system and using his ex-girlfriend's identity to try to get $140,000 worth of loans in her name. Let's put up the commissioner here. This is the New South Wales commissioner. Karen Webb oversaw the department, who quickly arrested the detective after the victim reported this misconduct. Now, let me say this, this was speedy. This was a speedy arrest. It's very sad that this individual operated in this fashion. And I gotta say this, if I were Miss Sonia, I would be concerned as well. I mean, what did the cop plan to do to her after he spent her money? That would be a question for me. I'm glad this criminal is off the street. All right, Mr. Mayor, thoughts here?
Listen, real quick, Doc. I just want to know who else and how many other people have been victim to this detective. Yep. How many people heard this aneurysm and you remind me of my grandmother's story and he's got away with it? This seems too comfortable for me for this to be his first time. I hope they're investigating in that and trying to figure it out. But this is also what happens when cops have this unweathered or untethered right to do and act as they please. He showed up in full uniform, full regalia, yep, to steal, to rob. His action, his weapon was his uniform, and this happens so often, and we blow over it like it ain't the norm.
Yeah, well said, and you're right. They have to investigate to see if he has other victims.